Hey everyone, my name is Ryan Wold, and I'm a Senior Support Escalation Engineer on the Surface Hub support team at Microsoft. In this video, I'll be going over how to verify the device account and personal user sign-in are working properly on a Surface Hub. As users return to the office, it's a good idea to confirm these features are working, as changes may have been made to your organization's security requirements that could affect device account or user sign-in. First, we'll start with verifying the device account is functioning properly. This is the account used to sync the Surface Hub's calendar with Exchange and sign into Teams. I'll show you how to do this while physically in front of the Surface Hub, as well as cover some things you can check remotely. While having access to the Surface Hub, we'll start by opening the Outlook client on a PC and inviting the Surface Hub device account to a Teams meeting. After sending the meeting invite, you should see it appear on the welcome screen of the Surface Hub. If everything is working properly, clicking the meeting should launch Teams and join the call automatically. This test confirms the device account is properly syncing with Exchange and able to sign into Teams. While still in front of the Surface Hub, I'd also recommend signing in with a user account to verify My Meetings and Files can be accessed. I'll do this by pressing Sign In to see your meetings and files on the welcome screen. I'll then click Worker School Account and continue. After signing in with my user credentials, I can see my meetings and files are displayed. When attempting to sign in, if you're greeted with a message that says you can't get to there from here, you're likely running into a conditional access policy blocking sign-in. If you run into this, I'd recommend looking at the Azure sign-in logs for this user account to see why it's being blocked. If you don't have physical access to a Surface Hub, there are still a few things we can check remotely to ensure the device account is in a good state. To start, on my Windows PC, I'll open the Edge browser and navigate to teams.microsoft.com. I'll then sign into Teams using the Surface Hub's device account. This test will confirm the account is enabled, a license is assigned, and the password is known and working. I'd also recommend looking at the Azure sign-in logs for the device account to see if there are any sign-in related errors there. For this, I'll head to endpoint.microsoft.com. Once signed in with an administrator account, click on Users in the left pane. I'll then select this Hub 20 account to take a closer look at it. Once loaded, I can see a graph of the sign-in history for this account, as well as the last sign-in date. If this date is current, that's a good indicator the Surface Hub has been powered on and signed into its account recently. If the last sign-in date is aged, that likely means the Surface Hub has been powered off, or there may be an issue with the device account. If that's the case, it may be worth having someone physically check the device to ensure it's plugged into the wall, not shut down, and has the device account successfully added. While here, let's take a look at the sign-in logs for this account to confirm we don't see any errors. If you don't see any data here, I'd recommend changing the log date to 7 or more days. For this account, I can see it has successful entries for signing into Azure AD, Exchange Online, and Whiteboard. If you see any failures here, it may be worth taking a closer look at them, but for this Hub 20 account, everything looks good. And that's how you verify the device account and personal user sign-in are working properly on a Surface Hub. Thanks so much for watching.